The Worst Chefs in Kitchen Nightmares, Part 2. Hello and welcome back to our channel film station. In this video, we are going to talk about the worst chefs in kitchen nightmares. So, let's get started. Before we start, I would like you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. 1. Mohammed. When it comes to Gordon Ramsay, all he cares about is quality and cleanliness. Perhaps these two things are explicitly missing from Muhammad's kitchen. As per what Mohammed claimed, his vision was to run an American-Irish restaurant with a pinch of Indian taste. However, the Indian chefs did not even know how to cook the American dishes. And as if this wasn't enough, the restaurant was home to a bunch of flies too. Just one word for it, gross. The restaurant served poor quality food to its customers, and the customers were quite unhappy with it. We totally get their disgust. 2. Michael Fernandez. Chef Michael Fernandez, who inherited his restaurant from his grandfather, used to co-manage it along with his mother Balbina and brother Jerry. However, there was trouble in paradise when the two brothers just could not stop fighting with each other on a daily basis, which used to ruin the decorum of the restaurant. To make things worse, they'd also had a dead lobster in their tank, which was taken quite seriously by Gordon. Michael was even caught on camera while assaulting a cook over some baseless feud. Unprofessionalism to the peak. Even though the restaurant still functions, Michael has nothing to do with it. 3. Jumanji. Believe it or not, this one is probably the worst one on this list. You would have the same thought too unless you appreciate the rudeness of the chef and staff. As opposed to Joe's claims that he offers fresh food from the farm, it was later discovered that the food was rather frozen and bought from the local grocery shops. 10 points for trying to fool the legend Gordon Ramsay himself. Plus, Joe was accused of being rude, selfish, and downright egoistic by many of his colleagues. He even had heated arguments with Gordon. 4. Sebastian DeMonica. It is really difficult to mix business with passion, and Sebastian is the perfect example of it. We are not too sure if he really wanted to be a chef or was acting his first love, but we even know one thing: that he did not get along with any of his customers or fellow chefs. He did try to put on a good show though, being all fancy with food decorations and plating, but he could not really fool anyone. He was obnoxiously weird. Eventually, he quit the whole chef thing and moved on with his business. 5. Nino Cristiano. Nino Cristiano is another one who inherited his restaurant from his parents. However, for someone who has seen his parents work hard to maintain the stature of the restaurant, he didn't seem bothered enough. Also, he mistook what his job meant, as it wasn't merely to keep the place clean. It was just one of the main duties. Even if he did think that it was indeed about cleaning, he failed miserably in that department too. Gordon Ramsay was taken aback when he found chewing gum under the tables and cobwebs, covering the entire place. Do you like the video so far? Keep watching until the end, as it is going to get even more intense. Let us know in the comments section about which one of the chefs is worst in your opinion. The show is known to bring up some of the worst chefs and people in management. And these guys that we are discussing, they are just another tier above everything else. 6. Mo. On reaching Mo's restaurant, Gordon Ramsay had to face the worst nightmare of his life. The place was extremely unpleasant and reeked of rotten vegetables. And what happened next was way out of line. Gordon saw a dead mouse in the kitchen. He could not take it anymore and was literally puking in a bucket the whole time while filming that episode. The drama further unfolded when Mo got so infuriated that he sued Gordon Ramsay and his show. They claimed that the scenes were morphed to show him in his restaurant in bad light. 7. Mitchell Bardivid. Gordon Ramsay had quite an interesting nickname to give to Mitchell, a French pig. And it was not for nothing. Mitchell had worked in several other French restaurants in the past, so he would think too highly of himself. That was not the case with Gordon Ramsay, as he knew exactly what he was capable of. Seeing his restaurant in a questionable condition, not only was it unclean, but the decor was outdated too. Moreover, the food was tasteless and cold, as if it was just out of the freezer. Oh, and did we mention the mold and maggots? Apologies if that made you feel sick. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen, because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.